INO stands for India-based Neutrino Observatory. This laboratory is being built in Tamil Nadu, India. Simultaneously, it aims to bring long-term benefits to India as a whole, in particular to Tamil Nadu and the Theni district, by promoting not only science and science training, but also growth in technology and local economy. What is INO? It's an entirely India-made underground laboratory. In the beginning, it aims to study some fundamental properties of one of the most interesting elementary particles called neutrinos. In fact, they exist all around us, within us and pass through us. About a trillion neutrinos emitted by the sun are passing through you and me every second, all our life, but we don't see them and we don't feel them. They cause no harm because they hardly interact at all. Second, they're not only friendly, but they are in fact essential for our existence in the following sense. It turns out that if there are no neutrinos, the mechanism for the sun to produce light and heat would simply stop, and life as we know won't exist.
The INO detector is a unique and advanced neutrino detector. The world neutrino community will really benefit by the data from INO. There is no doubt that the existence of these detectors will not cause any harm or hazard. But INO will clearly be a unique neutrino detector. INO will contribute to the basic science in the world, or more explicitly, the data from INO will largely contribute to our understanding of neutrinos, elementary particles, and the universe. In addition, the existence of world top-level experiments such as INO is very important for training the students. Students learn the cutting-edge technology and are exposed to the world community of scientists. Therefore, the students in Tamil Nadu and in India should benefit a lot with the INO experiment.
It's a basic understanding at the most fundamental level that we are very much hoping that the Indian science community with INO will be able to provide. The INO is a telescope, similar to the telescopes used to study light. It's a telescope that studies neutrinos, and it is placed underground because this is the most favorable location to observe these difficult-to-detect particles. But neutrinos themselves are a part of what comes to us from outer space. In fact, they are completely benign. They have no effect on human beings, and yet, if we can understand their properties and the ways that INO can help us to do, we can understand how our universe has evolved, because neutrinos have played a large role in that over the process of evolution of the universe. For your local scientists, for your local students, you'll be training people in the technology at the cutting edge of technology in order to accomplish this work. This creates people who are capable of going on to lead your scientific effort in universities, but it also creates people who are technically literate, can work in your industries, and can influence your future development of your country. That has been the case in Canada, and I'm sure it would be similarly the case in India.
Neutrinos switch neutrons into protons. And without them, the sun would not shine, and the air we breathe would not have formed in stars. They are part of nature, like birds and trees. One major difference, we cannot see them. To look at them, we need special glasses, and that is INO. It is a camera that allows us to look at the neutrinos that are present in nature and study them. Neutrinos help us to understand our universe and from the present day back to the very beginning. So INO will contribute to answering the most fundamental questions that we can ask about our very origins and those of the universe that we live in. Neutrinos cannot do harm. They are already present in nature anyway, and clearly do not harm us. It is important to realize that neutrinos are always passing through us at nearly the speed of light. They do not touch us. They just go through us unaware of our presence, just as we are unaware of their presence. By looking at neutrinos, INO sees the universe. This will inspire students of all ages in the state of Tamil Nadu and more widely in India, just as it does at several experiments elsewhere on Earth. Progress in understanding the physics of neutrinos has generated many Nobel Prizes already. INO provides the extraordinary opportunity to bring state-of-the-art scientific technology and computing to your area without the adverse environmental impact that is often associated with such developments.
Neutrino experiments like INO are completely benign because one is just tapping the neutrinos that are passing through us all the time. No country can progress without developing the expertise in technology and innovate therein. INO will offer immense opportunities to Indian industry and train it to make in India the components needed for the future detectors in particle physics in the world. Now, with INO, Indian particle physics will be taking the next step in executing an Indian and yet international program in India. Needless to say that mega projects like this can only benefit the local industrial economic development. The 1500 crore rupees to be spent on INO will not only bring a boost to the industry in any district, but in fact bring overall increased employment and development. INO could bring the same benefits to any district as the CERN laboratory did to Geneva in Switzerland. Hence, sooner the roadblock facing INO is removed, the better it would be for India, for Tamil Nadu, and for Thane district.
This kind of research started in India in 1950 at the Kola gold fields. The very first natural neutrino was observed by the Indian scientists in the year 1965, stimulating great excitement. Would like to study these particles that are already present in the environment, created in the atmosphere or emitted by the sun. This ever-present neutrino background has caused no harm over millions of years and never will in the future, either to man or to the environment. That is why, even at the South Pole, the most protected and pristine of all places, they allowed a similar instrument to be built. What are the benefits to the people of Tamil Nadu and to others? The neutrino observatory is like an advanced university. A large number of students will get trained in the latest fields of science and technology. It will be a center for excellent education. There will be tremendous economic benefit from such a major instrument. Moreover, it will stimulate the growth of local industry on a broad set of fronts: engineering, electronics, computer science, etc. And by ripple effect, it will create a large number of jobs.